I was like, what? I ran out of where I was hiding. They were startled. I was like, eh? It was a disgusting sight. I actually ran out and I saw the two of them kissing. I was like, what the hell is going on? And you know, she didn't even seem like, on a normal day, I assume what the woman would ask would be, who is she? That sort of thing. She never did that. So, yeah, she must have known me. And then he was kind of like in a shock for a few minutes. He did not know how to, you know, react to this. Whatever that is, what I shall know is that he kind of like tries to talk to me. Yeah, you know, da-da-da-da. What are we da-da-da in here? I'm very confused. Why is she here? And if she's here at this time of night, I assume you plan that your plan is to have her stay over, because I don't know. And then guess what, though? Guys, please don't forget this part of the story. I have my sexy outfit on. Uh-huh. It was a bodysuit. Correct, clingy body. Clinched. Abiha did the tokam. Holds the body together. I was standing right there, staring. The bodysuit was not my problem at that time. Like, who gives a shit what I'm wearing? My own was, what is going on? Because I'm extremely confused, you know. And was I going to start heading back to school that night? Or was I going to go to my dad's house? I don't understand. Like, I was so confused. Where would my father sit? Where will I tell him I'm coming from? Like, it was the strangest sight. I have never experienced such in my life. You know, I thought this only happened in movies. You see, that's what I say that a lot of times. I was standing there and, you know, I was, okay, guys, what is going on, blah, blah, blah. And then he's not even explaining to anyone, okay, this is that. He's like, you know, calm down. You know, tries to push me into one of the rooms so we can talk. And I'm like, I'm very confused. There's nothing to talk about. I want to understand what is going on here. And I just broke down. I started crying. Like, what the hell is this? Why is this happening to me? She goes and apparently she just sits somewhere in the living room, you know, pressing her phone and, you know, not necessarily, I mean, I don't even understand, you know, I was the one who was like really aggressive and all, you know, so he's like, I need to calm down, blah, blah, blah. I remember slapping him and I don't even know what happened next. But what I do know is I had to sleep in that house because it was already late. The whole chaos lasted a little over 2 hours. It was really late into the night. So I go to the guest room and I lay there crying myself. I couldn't even sleep. And guess what? He never came to me. Strike one. After the whole nonsense, he still stayed in a room with her. I slept in the guest room, crying my eyes out. In the morning, like 4 a.m., I got up, took a shower, packed my shit. I know he came out. She never did. I never saw her again, but she was inside the room somewhere. Who knows? Maybe they even bloody had sex. Who knows? At my own expense while I was crying somewhere. He comes to me and is like, okay, so where are you going? Oh yeah, I'm going to school. Never asked, are you okay? Or let's talk about it. Nothing like that. Strange. She was just standing there. He stood, leaned on the wall. I was watching me the entire time as I, you know, got ready, packed my stuff. The food that I even cooked, who knows? Maybe she even ate some of it. Oh God, generic. And I went, packed my stuff. The embarrassment. A few of my stuff were in the room because, you know, I'd already went straight there waiting for him before, you know, she came. I had to sleep in the guest room. So she was in the room and I had to take my stuff. So I went in there. This girl was just laying on the bed, pressing her phone as I walked in. She did as if a human being was not there. Walked in, took my stuff. He was still like standing in the corner, you know, watching. So I walked away. On second thought, I was like, it's not possible for her to just act like I don't make sense, that sort of thing. I don't know, like, this one no gets, I don't know how to explain it. So I went back to her in the room and I was like, in my words, I thought I was making sense, I was intelligent. I was like, I honestly want to understand how you would feel if you're walking on your boyfriend and you walk in seeing another woman and she's doing exactly what you're doing. Of course, she was looking at me. Before she could even say Jack Robinson, he ran into the room because he heard that we were speaking. Of course, he knew there was some kind of dialogue. So he went into the room and he was like, I don't want to call her name. He called her name and he's like, no, just ignore, you know, don't say anything. Please don't say anything. Hey, offense number two. Can you imagine? Like, watching over her ish. Is that what that was? I'm not sure. I'm telling her, you know, just ignore Don, you know, that sort of thing. Man, talking about it right now, I'm going crazy. Like, it's not even funny. So when he says that, I think I was there crying, Seth. Because when I was talking to her, I was kind of crying. Because like, what just happened? Like, how can something that's meant to be so good turn so bad so quickly? It was very strange. It's not a cartoon. Ridiculous. So I shower, went, took my stuff, and I left. I was even kind of like stalling going down the stairs. I was kind of like dragging my feet. What should be a 7-step transition downstairs lasted for a while because I thought he was going to kind of like run after me. At least I was hoping he would. Isn't that what he's meant to do? You know how, you know, it happens in these romance movies. When a person leaves, that's when you realize, oh my God, they're just doing this. I started running after her. I didn't see Pim, brake lights, shadow, nothing. And that's how I left, though. He didn't even see me off or, you know, take this money for transport or... It's not even... who gives a shit about that one? And that's how I left. I left. He never said goodbye. He never ran after me. He never tried to talk to me. I left and I went straight to school. Yo, like, I couldn't even tell my friends. The kind of laugh that they would have given me, no go get part two. They would have finished me, flawless victory. Like, they would have dragged me from here. Like, I kept it to myself. But one of my closest friends lived in my hall, you know, hall-ish hostel. When I got there, she saw me and already knew something was wrong. You know, she just asked and I just started crying. So I was holding that thing in my heart for a while. I cried like crazy. It was strange because even she had her mouth open the entire time. You know, the usual reaction every girl would have when you're telling them this kind of stories. Eh? That thing happened to you and you didn't drag the girl. You didn't beat her. Oh, Diego. That's not the beat. Beat what? You don't understand, like, when someone puts a knife through your heart. How is your first reaction to beat? Beat what? Why? You know. Don't forget I worked in a damn kitchen, yo. Like, how do you beat? What are you beating for? If she was an aggressor as well, maybe perhaps. But then she was just, like, really, like, I've never seen someone so calm through the storm. Like, I shot, you know, the entire week. Even, what am I saying, week? Months, man. For me to get over that thing was a while. This guy never called me. He never called me that day to even ask, okay, did you get to school? Or even the next day, or how are you doing? None of that. So strange. You know, he never did call me or anything. I shall try to get by with school and everything. When my friends have those comments about their boyfriends, my lips are completely quiet, zipped, mute. So guess what? Like 2 weeks later, that's how someone knocks on my door. And then this bastard shows up 2 weeks later. I opened the door and I saw this idiot standing right there with his face looking like 2 days old shit. To say what? To say what? To say what? How many times? I said what? You know, this is meant to be a story about heartbreak. I don't want to jump into another story because the other part is very interesting. If you want to hear what happened when I opened that door, put in the comments that I should give you more story because this story full bucket is very sweet. Write it in the comments if you want to hear the that's even the best part. If you want to hear it, write it in the comments, put it there, and I'll serve it to you guys hot food ready for you. I opened the door and he was standing right there. Doing what? For what? How? Where? What? Where? Why? As in, I said, oh, the anger where I know unleashed that day. Now for your body, I go unleash him today. If you want to hear the story and what happened eventually, I'm open to sharing. Waiting to hear from you.
Please share your experiences with us on the couch.